everybody. Happy Sabbath. I'm so glad that you're joining us here at Primary Virtual Sabbath School. Some of you are also attending in-person Sabbath School in the kindergarten room at Chapel Oaks. But guess what? Beginning Sabbath, February 6th, there will be in-person Sabbath School in the primary room. Isn't that exciting? I know you will want to be there. Now, let's join Alistair as he leads us in our sing and praise time today.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. Joy, down in my heart,
where?
What fun praising God. Thank you, Alistair. Boys and girls, do you remember last week? I challenged you to serve others out of love, just because you cared. I'm wondering what you did this week to help someone else. If you didn't get a chance to help someone, you still can this next week and any time after that. Needy people don't just come in the form of the homeless man or woman sitting on the street corner, do they? No, sometimes the needy person is a neighbor who lives in a big house all alone, and all they need is a friendly smile. Do needy people need our prayers? Yes, they do. We can pray for their needs to be met. Maybe they need shelter or food or medicine. Maybe they need a warm coat or a friendly smile. And sometimes we can even help God answer our prayers for the needy. We can be God's hands and feet. Let's pray now. Dear Jesus, please help us to notice the needs of others. Give us eyes to see what they need and what we can do to make their lives easier. Make us willing to be your hands and feet to serve even the people that we may not like or who are different than we are. Help us to show your love to everyone around us. Amen.
Good morning, primary class. It's time for our mission story. Today's mission story is about a girl named Marcia. Now, at the beginning of our story, Marcia was 6 years old, and she got to see her big sister get baptized. Do any of you have big siblings that have gotten baptized? And she watched and she said, I don't want to be baptized too. And she thought about it. She talked to her mom about it. And she was thinking about it, but then she thought, I don't know if I'm old enough. She said, I'm going to wait until I'm 10, and then I'm going to get baptized then. Well, the years went by and Marcia grew, and she turned 10. And she said to her mom, Mom, I really do want to get baptized now. It's time. I'm 10 now. And her mom said, okay, let's talk to our pastor about it. So they went to church and talked to their pastor about it. And he said, I think that's great that you want baptized. He said, let's get you into a baptismal class so that you can learn some things before you get baptized. She went to the baptismal class and, you know, she was learning a lot and she was enjoying it. But then her pastor left and went to a different church. her church got a new pastor. And the new pastor said, "You can't get baptized. You're too young." Marcia was really sad about that. But she said, okay. And so some time went by, and she turned 12. Now, in the meanwhile, she was mad at this pastor. She felt like, why is he saying I can't get baptized? She turned 12, and she said, "I think I still want to get baptized." And he said, "Okay, you can join the baptismal class again." And so she joined again, but she really wasn't into it. She just really couldn't get her mind and her heart into it. And she stayed there for 4 months. But you know what? She was still mad, and deep down in her heart, at that pastor for not letting her get baptized. Well, the school year rolled around, and her mom said, "You know, you're old enough now. How would you like to go to the nearest Seventh-day Adventist boarding school?" And so she went. But you know what? She was still kind of struggling and still kind of not that engaged. Well, she met a student pastor, and he started talking to her, and he said, "Do you talk to God like he's your friend?" And she thought about it. She said, "I really don't." He said, "You know, God wants to be our friend so badly, and he would love to spend time with you and to be your friend." Marcia thought, "I'm going to do that." And you know what she did? She started praying and spending time with God. She poured her heart out to God like he was her friend. She was kind of lonely at this new school, and she told God all about it. And you know, she said, "God, I'm so sorry I haven't talked to you like a friend before. You've been here all along for me." She said, "You know what? I'm also really sorry that I was mad for all that time at the pastor at my home church who thought I was too young to get baptized." Marcia has gotten baptized, and she still has a good relationship with God. She prays to God, and she says God is the best friend she could possibly have. I hope you guys are talking to God like he's your friend too. He truly is the best friend we can have.
Hi everyone, it's Aunt Franita. Today's story is called Heavenly Visitors. The memory verse is from Philippians chapter 2, verse 4. It says, "Not looking to your own interests, but each of you to the interests of the others." Today's message is God wants me to speak out for others. Do you talk to God when someone you care about needs help? Do you ask God to do something for them? Even when people are bad, we can speak out for them. A long time ago, Abraham bargained with God for some people. It happened like this. One hot day, Abraham sat in the shade of his tent, looking out upon the valley where he lived. A movement caught his eye. Three men stood just beyond his camp, talking together. Abraham jumped up, ran out to meet them, and bowed low. "Please, stay a while at my tent. I will give you water and some food to eat. You can sit in the shade of the trees and rest." "Thank you, we will," the men agreed. "Go, do as you have said." Abraham hurried back to the camp and into his tent. "Sarah," he called to his wife, "we have some guests. Please bake some bread for them." Then Abraham hurried to get food for his servant to cook. Soon the food was ready. Abraham himself served his guests. While they ate, he stood in the shade of a tree nearby. And Sarah stayed just inside the tent where she could listen to the men. "Where is your wife, Sarah?" one of the guests asked. "She's in the tent," Abraham answered. Next year, at this time, she will have a son, the guest said. Back in the tent, Sarah chuckled. Imagine, a son at her age? Why did Sarah laugh? The stranger asked. Is anything too hard for the Lord? Now both Abraham and Sarah knew that their guest was the Lord himself. When Abraham's guests finished their meal, they got up to leave. As was the custom, Abraham walked a short distance with them. The Lord stopped to talk to Abraham as the others walked on. I have heard how very wicked Sodom is, the Lord said. Abraham had heard of evil things that people did in Sodom. He thought of Lot and his family who lived there. Abraham loved his nephew's family. He was sure Lot was not wicked, but Abraham worried about the people of Sodom. Many of them did not yet know God. Lord, Abraham said, are you going to destroy the good people of Sodom along with the wicked? Suppose there are 50 good people in Sodom. Will you not save the city? The Lord answered, if I find 50 righteous or good people in Sodom, I will not destroy it. Abraham thought some more. His kind heart made him ask the Lord again. What if there are only 45 good people? I will not destroy Sodom if there are 45 good people. Still, Abraham was not satisfied. Three more times he asked the Lord to save the city. The sixth time, Abraham begged the Lord, don't be angry with me, Lord, but let me ask one more time. Will you save the city for just 10 good people? The Lord answered, for the sake of 10 good people, I will not destroy the city. Then the Lord went on to Sodom, and Abraham went back to his tent, knowing that God would do what was right and what was good.
Good morning, primary class, and happy Sabbath. It's time for our memory verse. This week's memory verse is, not looking to your own interests, but each of you to the interests of the others. Philippians 2:4. In today's lesson, we learned about when God told Abraham that he was going to destroy Sodom. Abraham felt compassion for his nephew Lot and the whole city of Sodom when God told him about that.
That's right. Abraham concerned himself with the interests of others and not his own interests, and so he was able to feel compassion for the people that lived in Sodom, and therefore he begged God to save them.
When we hear about other people who are hurting or going through hard times, we should feel compassion for them as well. We should look for ways that we can help them.
It may not always be obvious how we can help other people, but one thing we can always do to help others is to pray for them. Not only can this help other people, but God always knows the best way to help others. And so we should turn to Him for guidance.
Yes, that's right. And once we've prayed, we can also brainstorm with our parents to see if we can come up with ways to help other people.
Let's say our memory verse together one more time.
Not looking to your own interests, but each of you to the interests of the others. Philippians 2:4.
Let's play a game. I'll show you a picture of people who might need someone to speak out for them, while you listen to a short description of what happens in the situation. And then you give a thumbs up if the main character is looking out for the others, and give a thumbs down if they are not. Okay, you ready? Picture number one. The new student is sitting all by himself in the cafeteria. Sammy goes over to eat with him and starts a conversation. Is it a thumbs up or a thumbs down for Sammy? Picture number two. Taylor's friends are making fun of one of their classmates because of the clothes that she wears. Taylor doesn't join in the teasing, but she laughs at their jokes. Thumbs up or thumbs down for Taylor? Picture number three. Some older students take the ball away from a first grader and they throw it back and forth to each other way over his head. Tabitha gets another ball and plays catch with the first grader for a while. Would you give Tabitha a thumbs up or a thumbs down? Okay, so how do you think that the new student and Taylor's classmate and the little first grade student felt? I imagine they felt pretty lonely, didn't they? And sad and upset. Yes, do you think, let me ask you this, do you think Taylor was looking out for others? Remember, she was the one who laughed at the joke. Think about it. Is it okay to keep silent or just laugh while others are being teased, as long as you're not teasing the person also? Jesus loves us, and he wants us to love each other. Part of loving others is speaking out for them when they are being mistreated in some way. In our Bible story today, boys and girls, you remember Abraham wanted to help the people who lived in Sodom. So what did he do? He asked God to spare the city for the sake of the few good people who lived there. Prayer is the first thing we should do to help others. We should ask God to show us the best way to help that person. We can pray for people and let them know that we care. What do you think about asking God to do something special for someone else? Do you think God will answer your prayers? God wants us to speak out for others. And I'm excited to tell you that there will be special meetings for kids like you to talk to God and speak out for others, starting this Wednesday evening, January 27, at 6:30 to 7:30, and each evening through February 4. There will be 10 days of prayer for kids at the Chapel Oaks Church. Isn't that exciting? I hope you can be there. Ask Mom and Dad to take you, and be sure and tell them that there will be meetings for grown-ups too. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, please help us have the courage to speak out for others who need your help. Thank you that we can pray and ask you to help people we love and care about because you love them too. Please help the moms and dads and the kids to come to 10 days of prayer where we can pray together. We love you, Jesus. Amen. Well, it's time to go now, boys and girls, but I hope that you'll be back at Chapel Oaks Church for in-person 10 days of prayer for kids this Wednesday. Be sure and tell Mom and Dad about it. Bye now.